In this video, we continue with the topic of DC-DC converters, where we focus on the other types like boost, back-end boost, and the dual active bridge converters. The main learning objective will fall under the four main questions. First, how will a boost converter be operated? Secondly, how will a combination of a back and boost converters be made? And thirdly, how does the full bridge and dual active bridge work? And fourth, what are the main applications of these DC-DC converters in the microgrids? Step-up or so-called boost converters are widely employed to increase the level of the input DC voltage. The DC-DC conversion is conducted typically through a switch and a diode. Note that due to the placement of the diode at the output, the flow of the current from the output to the input is not possible for a boost converter. The output voltage of a boost converter is calculated by the input voltage divided by 1 minus the duty cycle. This can be proved by a simple equation. How can you transfer power to the higher voltage as current naturally flows from the higher potential level or higher voltage to lower one? To transfer the power to the higher output voltage levels become possible in the boost converters as the energy stored in the inductor first increases by the input voltage source during the on time period. During the on state of the switch, the voltage across the inductor is equal to the input voltage that is shown by the green area, and the inductor current linearly increases. The capacitor supplies the load and therefore the output voltage starts to decrease. Then the energy stored in the inductor is provided to the output during the off time of the switch, as it is shown by the red area. During this period, the capacitor is charged where the output voltage increases. How can we make a DC-DC converter topology which would be able to step up and transfer power from the lower to higher voltage, and at the same time step down and transfer the power back from the higher to lower voltage? We can combine the previous two topologies, namely the back converter and the boost converter, and we create the so-called back and boost topology. This topology consists of two switches, which are equipped with the two anti-parallel diodes. This combination is not so straightforward. The new converter is boost from the left to the right and back from the right to the left. Let us have a look at this converter in more details. This converter should be able to transfer power from lower voltage V in to higher voltage V output, and also vice versa. By combining back and boost, a DC-DC back and boost converter is made, as it is shown in the figure. Here we analyze in detail the operation of one back and boost converter. As it can be seen, two switches, S1 to S and S2, are connected across a DC voltage source Vin. Each switch consists of an IGBT with anti-parallel diode. The switches open and close alternatively in such a way that when S1 is closed, S2 is open and vice versa. The time of the cycle is T and the S1 is closed for a period T on. It follows that the duty cycle of S1 is D equal to the T on divided by T, while the S2 is 1 minus D. Let us analyze the boost operation. If S1 is conducting, the energy in the inductor is stored. When S1 is off, the diode of S2 takes the current over and delivers energy to higher voltage levels V output. The back operation is when the switch S2 is conducting. When S2 is off, the freewheeling diode of S1 takes the current over. By varying the duty cycle D from 0 to 1, we can vary the current direction. The current can flow in either direction, but the polarity of the DC voltages, V in and V output, remains fixed. It is called a two-quadrant converter because current can flow in either direction, but the polarity of the DC voltages remains fixed. By controlling switch 1, the behavior of the boost topology is achieved, while switch 2 can be controlled to obtain the back behavior. During the on-time period, the inductor current derivative depends on the input voltage, while during the off-time period, the derivative depends on the difference of the input and output voltage. Note that in this topology, both switches 1 and 2 cannot be closed at the same time since the output will be short-circuited. Indeed, in the next step, we can create a more detailed converter by using two buck and boost converters, the so-called full bridge. Full bridge will provide 4-quadrant power flows capabilities. A more complete type of DCC converter is a full bridge DCC converter, which is a two-leg four-switch converter. As we will discuss in more details later, the full bridge is able to provide 4-quadrant of power, meaning bidirectional power flow power with both positive and negative voltage polarities. Note that the bidirectional flow becomes possible thanks to the diodes in anti-parallel with the switches. These converters have a higher reliability compared to the buck and boost converters. The full bridge is also does not provide very high efficiency and is not able to achieve a large ratio between input and output voltages. To obtain a large ratio between input and output voltages, solution is that the DC voltage is first inverted to the AC, and then using a transformer, the voltage is stepped up or down, and finally the AC voltage is converted to DC. The DC to AC inversion can be performed through a two-leg two-switch converter, and in the simplest form, a diode bridge can be used to convert the AC to the DC. However, as we will discuss in detail later, the diode bridge doesn't allow the current flow from the output to the input. To overcome some shortcomings of the previously discussed converters, here we introduce another type of DC-DC converter, the so-called dual active bridge converter, which has gained significant both research and industry attention. The dual active bridge converter is popular because of the presence of the isolation high-frequency transformer, bidirectionality, and also having a very simple control and very high efficiency, reaching up to 99%. Due to this, they are seen as the potentially one of the fundamental building blocks for future microgrids. In the dual active bridge converter, the input DC voltage, Vin, is primarily converted to the AC voltage through a DC-AC inverter. Then this AC voltage is flexibly stepped down or up using a high-frequency transformer. Finally, the transform AC voltage is converted to the output DC voltage, Vout, through a AC to DC converter. The primary inverter and secondary converter may include four switches. The power flow is controlled by modulating the voltage at the leakage inductance of the transformer. Due to the presence of the leakage inductance, LK, the block forms of the transformer voltages show a phase shift given by the X factor, which gives the phase difference time X times T. After the T0, the voltage at the primary side of the transformer is positive, while it is still negative at the output of the transformer. This produces a sharply increasing DC current over the leakage inductance. After XT, the voltages are in phase with a small difference over the LK, leakage inductance, which gives a small increase in the current between low and high current. Again, the phase shift after T divided by 2 will result in a sharp decrease of the current. So the control of the current is given by the phase shift, therefore by X. Hence, changing the X, it is possible to change the power transfer. X is controlled by changing the phase shift over the leakage inductance. DC-DC converters are used in a wide range of applications. Particular boost and buck converters are broadly employed for regulated switchmode power supply applications, as it is shown in the figure. Also, they are used for power electronic interface DC motors, for example, boost converter for generative braking, and buck converter for driving such motors. Note that the machines connected through the power electronic interface can be operated in four quadrants. While the motoring forward quadrant is for the positive voltage and current, the forward braking is for the positive voltage and negative currents. These quadrants are very important for the proper operation, and this is why in the next videos we will focus on the different classes of DC-DC converters based on the four quadrants. In the previous video and this video, we introduced commonly known DC-DC power converters. Buck or step-down converter have one switch, which is simple and the high efficiency greater than 95% with the polarity output voltage and unidirectional output current. Boost or step-up converters also have one switch and are very simple. They have high efficiency with one polarity output voltage and unidirectional output power that requires a larger filter capacitor and a larger inductor than those of a buck converter. To obtain bidirectional power flow, a buck and boost converter can be created, adding one additional switch. On top of this, full bridge DCC converter allows bidirectional flows of the current, however, it is not able to provide a very high efficiency. Therefore, dual active bridges are introduced that are able to also provide high isolation, efficiency, and bidirectional power transfer capabilities thanks to the high frequency transformer.